Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. In this video today, I'm going to show you how to add word-by-word subtitles in DaVinci Resolve. So it'll look just like the ones that are showing up on the screen right now. So the process is pretty easy, though you'll do need DaVinci 18.5 Studio or newer. Without that, you won't be able to use this process. So we'll just jump straight into it. So the first thing you need to do is open DaVinci Resolve, import your project. So this is one I'm going to be using here. It's got an audio track with voice. So once you've got something like that, just go up to the media pool here, top left corner, find your audio file. So that's the one I'm going to use. So just right click on it, scroll down and go to audio transcription and transcribe. Depending on your PC, this will take a little while to generate, and it'll generate a little audio track like this. Sorry, I should say a text track of your audio like this. So I've already made a couple of changes in this one, but I'll just revert those for the purpose of the video. So that's our audio track as standard. And this little dot here represents silence. So if we want to remove the silence, we can just select it and press backspace. That'll remove it. However, you can also do the same for parts of the video you don't want. So if we didn't want this text here, we can just highlight it, right click on it and select delete. So that option there, this one here will restore it, or you can just press backspace on the keyboard. And the strike through will show that it's been removed. So that's how you remove a part of the video that you don't want subtitles for. However, for this video, we're just going to leave everything as it is so we can just close the transcript. Okay, so now that we have a audio track and text file generated, we can add the subtitle track to the DaVinci Resolve project. To go to timeline, scroll down and go to create subtitle from audio. So we'll open this little window here. Just leave it set to auto for language. Caption presets you can leave at default, unless you want to choose one of these two, but default's fine. Then for maximum, set this to 1. That's characters per line, so which is basically going to be words per line. Then lines, set it to single, unless you want double line subtitles, but single works best for this. Then you can just leave the gap between subtitles as 0, then click create. Again, this will take a little bit of time to generate. Okay, so that's created a subtitle track just here and placed it above our timeline. So depending on how many video tracks you have, this may be higher or lower, but it'll be just like that. So once you've done that, select the subtitle track, then make sure you have the inspector window open. So just up here, make sure the inspector window is open. Stay on the video tab, change from caption to track, and then here we can customize our texts. Okay, so that's what the defaults are going to look like just here. We're going to customize these. So if we zoom in to the timeline, each one of these is our current subtitle track. So each one of these little sections is essentially going to be one word. However, when you make the change, it's going to change the entire subtitle track. So for example, let's go to an easy to read section. Now that we're on track, we'll change our font to a stereotypical one for this kind of thing. We're going to use Comica Access. It's a pretty common YouTube one. I'll leave a link in the description for you to download it if you don't already have it. And we can adjust the size. So we're going to go quite big for this. Then we're going to adjust the position under the transform section. So we've got X and Y. X will go left to right. Y will go up and down. So I'll just reset that quickly. Just adjust it to the center. And as we click play, we'll see that's our new subtitle track. Now you'll see some sections like this, which will appear with two words. Unfortunately, that's unavoidable because it does need to space out the single words and the track. So sometimes it will place two words on one line. It doesn't usually go more than two, but sometimes it will do that. It's completely unavoidable because it still needs to keep everything in sync. As well as that, you've got a ton of other options here. Just adjust it as you need. Just make sure you don't go too big with the size, as you can see, and the position. Also, whatever you make changes in here, it's going to affect the entire subtitle track. It's going to be uniform across the entire thing, just like that. If you only want the subtitles to appear for a single section, you can just select the parts of the timeline you don't want and press backspace. That will delete the subtitle track from the project, so you can just keep those in sections. So once you have fully customized your subtitle track, the next thing is to export it. So by default, it won't include a subtitle track, so you need to add this in and you need to set it to burn to your project. So change to the delivery tab, just at the bottom, then customize your export settings as you normally would. Then scroll down to the very bottom, go to subtitle settings, expand that, and you'll see a new list. So once that's done, click export subtitle, change the format to burn into video, click add to render queue, select a location, and then just render all. That's the entire process, and you'll have your subtitle track word by word exported into your project. Anyway, that wraps up this guide. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you on another video. Cheers, everyone.